Dude. There it is, in all its glory. Made of four small letters, two of which are D's and two of which are vowels. Dude is spelled D-U-D-E. Defined simply as a man or a guy, dude has an extensive semantic and cultural history. Through Duke University's American Speech Periodical, University of Pittsburgh's Associate Linguistic Professor Scott F. Kiesling released his examination of dude in 2004. Here is his definition. Dude indexes a stance of cool solidarity, a stance which is especially valuable for young men as they navigate cultural discourses of young masculinity, which simultaneously demand masculine solidarity, strict heterosexuality, and nonconformity. Boring. Come now as we explore the origins of dude.
Dude.
The Oxford English Dictionary says dude calls New York its home, popping up around 1883. Historians speculate dude came from either the Irish dude or the German dude. Dude may have meant rags, which changed to mean scarecrow. Closer inspection reveals the rags. From there, dude evolved to mean dandy, which meant a sharp-dressed man, particularly in the West. This led to dude ranches. Finally, in the 30s and 40s, dude began to mean cool. As time progressed, it began to take on negative connotations, in reference to slackers. Finally, dude reached the 70s, where it was turned into a term of respect. It has begun to take on a multipurpose role, acting as any part of speech, much like another four-letter word.
Dude.
In Kiesling's paper, he examines the use of dude between genders. Here, his studies reveal a much higher male-to-male use of dude, followed by the female-female use. Then Kiesling categorizes the five types of dude. Exclamation, confrontational stance mitigation, marking discourse and structure, marking affiliation and connection, and signaling agreement. Here, we see dude and its frequency as it appears in different parts of a sentence. But how did dude come to mean what it means today?
Dude?
Dude has many connotations and modern uses, but it must have changed from 1883 to 2008. Cultural catalysts have morphed dude into what it is today. The four following cinematic experiences directly led to the development and integration of the word dude into everyday life. First is Fast Times at Ridgemont High. One character in particular, Jeff Spicoli, represents the counterculture dude becomes associated with in the movie. Watch.
Why are you continuously late for this class, Mr. Spicoli? Why do you shamelessly waste my time like this?
Oh no.
And now a perfect example of dude being used. Watch.
Hey dude, I'll pick you up in the van and go to the dance.
The next and least well-known movie is Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure. Watch here as these two clowns push dude further into modern vocabulary and give it a slacker's bad rap. Watch.
How's it going, royal ugly dudes?
Put them in the Iron Maiden.
Excellent!
Execute them.
Bogus.
Perhaps the dudeliest of any movie is The Big Lebowski. Dude is central to this movie. The main character even proclaims himself as a dude. Watch.
I'm the dude. His dudeness, duder, or, El Duderino.
But perhaps the best example of dude and its associations is found in Dude, Where's My Car? This clip speaks for itself. Watch.
Dude, you got a tattoo!
So did you, dude!
No!
Oh! Dude, what does my tattoo say?
Sweet! What about mine?
Dude, what does mine say?
Sweet! What about mine?
Dude, what does mine say?
Sweet! What about mine?
Dude, what does mine say?
Sweet! What about mine?
Dude, what does mine say?
Sweet! What about mine?
Dude, what does mine say?
Sweet! What about mine?
Dude!
What does mine say?
Sweet!
If all this duding around has piqued your attention, visit www.dudism.com, home to the Church of the Latter-day Dude, where the motto is, just take it easy, man.
Dude.
Thank you for participating in this cultural education seminar. You are now excused, dude.